This is Kugan Cassius for iFILM London. We're at the premiere for Piggy here at the West End. With me, I've got one of the actors of Piggy, Ed Skrein. How are you, sir?
I'm very well, my friend. How are you?
I was panicking about getting your name wrong.
Well, you got it right. You're all right, don't worry.
I'm all right.
My character in Piggy, I'm a nice guy anyway. You're allowed to get it wrong a couple of times. Then I'll turn into that character.
Okay, I'll watch out. Ed, obviously we spent a lot of time on the set of Piggy and you know you spoke to iFILM London while you were making the film. Just retouching on a little bit about your character, can you tell us a little bit?
Well, he's a nasty piece of work to start off with. He's a character called Jamie Rittler. He's integral to the plot in the sense that, you know, it is a revenge thriller. And, you know, he's the one which that murders Neil Maskell, that causes the, you know, the vigilante revenge. And he was great fun to play, you know. I suppose it's easier being a horrible cunt than a, you know, a nice guy. But no, it was good fun.
Kieran Hawkes making his first film, feature film. How did you follow his direction? You know, what sort of director was he?
Do you know, I'm backing Kieran 200%. I think he's got such a great future ahead of him. You know, the way he edited Turnout, I thought was fantastic editing. That was actually my favourite thing about the movie, the editing. And, you know, after speaking to him when I was offered the part, that was what sold it to me. You know, and the way the synopsis was written, the script, everything about it was just so together, and Dark Side as well, you know, and we love the Dark Side, you know, so no, it was pretty much all Kieran, the reason that I came on board, you know. I wish him the best of luck for the future. I really hope that he carries on this positive escalator that he's on at the moment, you know.
Can you tell us anything about any future projects that you're involved with or working on right now, Ed?
Well, obviously we've got Ill Manners coming out and June the 6th, which you know should be quite a big deal. I got a part in The Sweeney, which was fantastic. Did a couple of scenes with Ray Winston, which is like, you know, any British man, let alone British actor, you know, that's what you want to be doing. I got a couple of really good scripts in the inbox. I just got offered a really interesting one the other day, which I won't talk about right now because it's not sorted yet. But it's a really interesting. It's a really interesting take on London films, and my whole thing is like, right, we're in this privileged position now where we can represent our generation, because I feel like, you know, I'm 28, I don't know about you, but how old are you?
30.
Oh, that's all right, same thing. But, you know, I've always felt like our generation has been misrepresented, albeit through the white, you know, possibly the white Cockney films or, you know, the black urban films. I felt like, well, you know, where are we? Because, like, you know, my crew was, you know, Bengali, Turkish, English, African, Caribbean, do you know what I mean? And it's like we've never been represented properly. So we're in this privileged position now where we can represent that. But a lot of the scripts that I read are just like, come on now, you're just rehashing over the same old thing. And this new script that I've got, which I'm not going to tell you about it, is really interesting because it's a really nice spin on you know, street life in London. And that's what I'm interested in exploring, man, and representing, you know what I mean? Let's try and rep our generation properly without the cliches and the negative connotations that seem to be following us around everywhere, especially with the riots and all that, you know?
All right, Ed Skrein, thank you very much for talking to iFILM London again. We look forward to seeing the film. We haven't seen it ourselves yet. And,
I haven't seen it either.
Well, we're all in the same boat
then.
I'll
be honest, this is actually the first time I'm ever going to walk into the cinema and watch myself. So I would have thought I'd be nervous, but yeah, I'm kind of excited, man. I'm looking forward to it. But yeah, so it's a unique thing. Do you know what I mean? I remember where I was in Euro 96. Remember where I was when I heard Eminem for the first time, you know? And I'm going to remember who I was talking to before I saw myself on a big screen. And if I run out in tears, then follow me with the hanky, all right?
No problem, yeah. Sir. Thank you very much for talking to iFILM London.
That's fine.
Thank you.
Pleasure.